Australians are bracing for another cash rate rise when the Reserve Bank of Australia meets today. Our political reporter Stella Todorovic joins us live from Parliament House. Stella, good morning. What can we expect today?
Well, Lockie, the expectation is the cash rate will go up by 50 basis points, taking it above 2% for the first time in 6 years. It's currently at 1.85%, and a half a percentage point rise would take it to 2.35%, meaning Australians are going to be paying around an extra $1,000 a month on those mortgage repayments. Repayments for an $800,000 mortgage will jump above $4,000 a month, and economists are tipping that these rate hikes will continue until they hit 3 or 3.5%. There is growing pressure on the federal government to do more to provide Australians with immediate relief, especially with the cost of everything else going up as well. Lockie?
The hits just keep coming. Stella, thank you so much. An elderly woman has died and two children are in critical conditions after a house fire in Melbourne's northeast. The fire engulfed the home on Marilee Drive in Moorabbin around 9 p.m. When emergency crews entered, they found the woman with injuries to her stomach and two unconscious children. They were all treated, but the woman sadly could not be saved at the scene. The boy and girl were rushed to hospital, suffering smoke inhalation. Meanwhile, three people have been hospitalised with severe carbon monoxide poisoning after a faulty heater spewed out the toxic gas in Western Sydney. Shortly after 10 o'clock last night, fire crews responded to a home at Rose Hill after concerned family members raised the alarm. Equipped with breathing apparatus and gas detectors, the crews quickly realised the silent killer fumes had filled the home. They managed to pull out two men and an elderly woman before providing treatment. Four children are among seven passengers who've been treated for minor injuries after their coach crashed down an embankment in the New South Wales Snowy Mountains. It had been carrying about 40 people when it lost control near Perisher. Thankfully, no one was seriously injured. The United Kingdom is entering a new political era this morning, and leading it is Liz Truss. The Foreign Secretary is Britain's next Prime Minister, and she's already making some big promises. Our Europe correspondent, John Paul Gonzo, has filed this report from London.
The UK's fourth Prime Minister in 6 years and the third woman to lead the country. Liz Truss takes the reins at one of the most challenging times in Britain's history.
It's an honour to be elected as leader of the Conservative and Unionist Party.
The result of the five-week leadership contest was closer than expected. Liz Truss secured just over 81,000 votes, while 60,000 people backed former Chancellor Rishi Sunak. The Foreign Secretary will now head to Balmoral in Scotland with Boris Johnson to be officially appointed by the Queen.
Boris, you got Brexit done. You crushed Jeremy Corbyn. You rolled out the vaccine and you stood up to Vladimir Putin. You were admired from Kiev to Carlisle.
A new-look cabinet will soon be announced and ministers will be expected to find solutions to the UK's soaring energy prices, putting unprecedented pressure on families. Liz Truss has pledged urgent tax cuts and a relief package within the first week of her government.
She needs to deal with the cost of living crisis, she needs to deal with the fact the NHS is on its knees, and she needs to deal with the collapse of law and order.
But one of Liz Truss's biggest jobs will be uniting a divided party. Boris Johnson has offered his congratulations to his replacement, urging his colleagues to back their new leader.
And from one new PM to another, Anthony Albanese has said he looks forward to a continued constructive friendship between Australia and the UK.
I know that we will deliver, we will deliver, we will deliver.
Liz Truss has time to make good on that promise. A general election isn't expected until 2024. John Paul Gonzo for 10 News First, London.
In breaking news, Canadian police have just provided an update on their manhunt after a wave of stabbing attacks that killed 10 people. One of the two suspects has been found dead, while his brother remains on the run. Here's what detectives had to say a short time ago.
At 11:30 a.m., a deceased male was located on the James Smith Cree Nation. At 1:17 p.m. today, it was confirmed by Saskatchewan RCMP Forensic Investigation Section that the deceased is Damien Sanderson. His body was located outdoors in a heavily grassed area in proximity to a house that was being examined. We can confirm he has visible injuries. These injuries are not believed to be self-inflicted at this point.
Now, police believe his brother, Miles Sanderson, may also be injured. They say he is dangerous with a lengthy criminal record and are urging the public not to approach him. An earthquake has killed at least 46 people in China's southwest, and the death toll is expected to rise. The magnitude 6.8 quake struck shortly after midday local time in the Sichuan province. Rescue crews raced to dig residents out from beneath the rubble of their homes. Last week, though, 21 million residents in the region's capital, Chengdu, were ordered to stay home to isolate because of COVID-19. The quake triggered landslides and have severed telecommunications in several towns, complicating the rescue efforts. More than a dozen people have been reported missing and 50 have been injured. A Queensland family is mourning the death of their son, who has been killed by Russian forces in Ukraine. The Australian government has confirmed 27-year-old Jed Danahoy died almost 2 weeks ago on the Eastern Front line. The Aussie firefighter was working as a combat medic helping Ukrainian troops when the enemy targeted his vehicle. Russian missiles do continue to bombard residential areas. Large parts of the country's east are without gas, water and electricity. Authorities are warning a difficult winter lays ahead. AFL legend Wayne Carey has found himself in trouble after dropping a bag of white powder at Perth's Crown Casino. The former North Melbourne captain was booted from the venue last Thursday night after the bag fell from his pocket. He's been banned from the complex for 2 years and has stood down from footy commentating roles on both radio and TV. Carey claims, though, the Ziploc bag didn't contain any illegal substances and was full of crushed-up anti-inflammatory drugs that he uses for pain management. A Qantas insider has lifted the lid on the potentially devastating cutbacks the airline is facing. A former staff member has told the ABC Four Corners program they fear the business model of outsourcing cheaper and inexperienced staff will only lead to disaster. It has been a bumpy ride for Qantas, unable to cope with soaring demand since domestic and international travel returned after the COVID restrictions were lifted. The airline laid off thousands of experienced staff and replaced them with more cost-effective employees to stay afloat in 2020. Next week, there is a strike by baggage handlers who are employed by the contractor that the airline now uses. Meanwhile, thousands of Aussies have been stranded in Bali after a number of Jetstar flights were cancelled. 8 East Coast return services have been scrapped since the start of the month, while delays of up to 24 hours are also plaguing passengers. The airline says their Boeing 787 fleet has been hit by a lightning strike, a bird strike, and they're also blaming problems sourcing spare parts.
I cancelled my flight and just rebooked with Qantas because I was just determined to get away on my holiday, but it cost me an extra $1,200 to do that.
We do have travel insurance, which only covers up to a certain amount anyway. But yeah, we were just, I guess, disappointed and upset with the lack of support and empathy from Jetstar.
Jetstar says it does apologise for the frustration and it is now offering flight credits.